Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. Here in the UK, the warmer, sunnier weather is approaching my least favourite time of year. I am a winter person. But what that does mean is that I like to test a load of sunscreens and kind of fill you in on what I feel are some of the best sunscreens going at the moment. And today I'm specifically going to be talking about Korean sunscreens. We all know that Korean sunscreens are far superior. Yes, a lot of drugstore brands nowadays are kind of formulating their sunscreens to feel just like the elegant, light formulations that we know Korean sunscreens for, but there is nothing like the original. I feel Korean sunscreens are always that little bit more interesting. A few ingredients here and there that you don't usually see in sunscreens that are really beneficial as well. And today's video is sponsored by StyleKorean.com. You should know StyleKorean now. It's one of my go-to websites to shop for all K-beauty. Korean skincare being one of my niches, and still to this day, StyleKorean always show me brands I've never heard of before. New up-and-coming brands, and you have all your iconic K-beauty brands in there as well. I always have to mention their time deal section where you can pick up a bargain, or an actual bargain. Go and check out the discounts on that bit. You also have food on there. I bought some snacks off there. They're really nice, as well as K-pop. So please go and check out StyleKorean.com to restock on your faves and to discover some new stuff as well. So let's get into it. I'm gonna kind of start off with the base sunscreens that I really, really love, and then some amazing sunscreens to help you top up during the day. So if you are familiar with my product reviews, then you will recognize this one. This is the Birch Moisturizing Sunscreen SPF 50 Plus PA 4 Pluses from Round Lab. There's many things I love about this sunscreen. I think I'm kind of starting with one of my most favorite sunscreens of all time. This has an ingredient in called birch tree sap. Now that is one of my favorite hydrating ingredients because not only is it really nicely hydrating, but also reduces inflammation. We have some skin barrier protecting amino acids in here, as well as niacinamide to help even out that skin tone, help with the oily greasiness from our skin, reducing redness, and hyaluronic acid to help hydrate. What I love about this is it just feels like a moisturizer. It just feels like a moisturizer. And that's gonna be like a current theme throughout my favorite sunscreens at the moment. I think it's honestly throughout K-beauty sunscreens, you don't feel like you're wearing a sunscreen. And to me, that's a nice thing because the sunscreens that we're used to from drugstores here in like the UK and in America, you can tell you're wearing a sunscreen. They smell, they're a little bit stingy. Some of them leave a white cast. You know, there's sometimes it feels like a real effort to use a sunscreen, but when it just feels like a moisturizer that you finish your routine with anyway, they're just a pleasure to use, easy to use, and so much easier to reapply throughout the day as well, without having to check if it's caught in your beard, if it's rubbed in properly in certain places. I have a very oily T-zone. I used to be oily everywhere, but one thing I used to hate about sunscreen reapplication, especially in summer, was reapplication. The more I built up sunscreen, the oilier and greasier I would feel. But with these sunscreens I'm sharing today, it just feels like you're reapplying a nice light moisturizer that doesn't sit on top of itself, doesn't travel around the face down into your eyes. It's more that hydrating, watery feel rather than like a greasy, sheeny shield, you know? On that note as well, we have the Skin 1004. Someone told me how to pronounce this properly and I completely forgot. But this is their Madagascar Centella Hyla Seeker Water Fit Sun Serum SPF 50 Plus PA 4 Pluses. You know that I love this range of products. I love this brand, but in particular, their Hyla Seeker line. It's obviously mainly about hydrating and moisturizing the skin, as well as soothing and calming. And the Hyla Seeker is, of course, hyaluronic acid and Centella Asiatica to help heal, soothe, nourish, as well as hydrate. And you can feel this in this product. I love this. I love this. When I first saw this, I was like, that's weird. Like, I'm not sure I'm going to like that. But it just makes pumping out nice and smooth. But you can feel that watery hydration again on the skin. This, again, feels like a super lightweight moisturizer rather than a heavier, slightly sticky sunscreen. Something we all know K-beauty sunscreens are renowned for. Again, we have niacinamide in here as well. We all know what niacinamide does. But for me, again, it's just the texture. As somebody with now combination skin and someone with rosacea, that chemical sunscreens seem to trigger pretty easily nowadays. I never used to have that issue, but now I do have to, you know, carefully select the sunscreens that I use. This is non-irritating for my skin, doesn't sting anywhere, and does just feel nourishing enough for the dry bits, hydrating and light enough for my oily T-zone, and again, I can reapply and reapply and reapply without feeling bogged down in product. Benton Airfit UV Defense Sun Cream. I first of all got this confused with an old one they used to do. This one is different, but this has already become like a staple in so many people's routine. Again, this is SPF 50 plus PA 4 pluses. My favorite thing in here is the combination of centella and panthenol. Really soothing, really calming. They've gone in and kind of shoved the whole centella plant in here. What do we have? We have madicacicide, madicacic acid, asiaticicide, asiatic acid. Again, niacinamide. Did I say that already? Niacinamide's in here. All chemical filters, but this one in particular leaves you with a very nice, smooth finish on the skin. I would say if you're a makeup wearer, this is probably going to make the nicest kind of base. So whilst this does feel like a super quickly absorbing, lightweight, hydrating sunscreen, you are left with a silky finish, which usually I don't like. You're just left with this smooth finish. It doesn't feel like too, how to explain, it doesn't feel too silicone-y, I guess you can say. Bit of a broad thing to say, but you know, but that stereotypical feel of like a silicone-y primer, it doesn't feel like that, it just feels nice and smooth. And then we have vitamin E in here as well, great antioxidant to work alongside sunscreen, help fight against free radical damage. So I would recommend this one for makeup wearers. If you're very oily, this one might be a little bit too much with reapplication for you, but I'll show you what you can do. If you want to use this one as a base for your makeup, then you can reapply with other things I'm going to show you. But yeah, again, a really, really nice one that I know a lot of makeup wearers love. Mixoon is a brand whose products I use on and off. I really enjoy their essences. They come in very tiny bottles though, but I really, really like them. So I had to try one of their sunscreens. Again, you'll notice I've kind of gone for a bit of a pattern here. It's the Centella Sun Cream SPF 50 plus PA 4 pluses. I love Centella in sun cream. As I mentioned, someone with rosacea, easy irritated skin, some sunscreens can make my skin stingy. It can, you know, I flush a lot during the day with chemical sunscreens in particular. When there's ingredients like Centella in it or panthenol, my skin seems to be absolutely fine. So yeah, Centella is something that I've kind of been reaching for and looking out for even when it comes to sunscreens. This is one of the weirdest, nice, but weirdest textures when it comes to a sunscreen that I've used. When you first apply it, when I first tried this, I was like, oh, it looks very thick. It felt very thick. It felt a bit like one of those really thick creams that your skin feels a little bit sweaty under, if you know what I mean. But the moment I started rubbing on my skin, it just kind of turns into this watery, fluidy, hydrating mixture that just disappears on the skin with some really, really nice moisturizing, soothing, hydrating properties. So if you are really oily, you can just do your two fingers full of sunscreen. Your face will be absolutely fine. Reapply with no issues throughout the day. If you're dry, you may not find this heavy enough. Like, it's very different to this. If you're oily, you are going to love this. You'll absolutely love this. I see a lot of people talk about sunscreens and they're like, you know, sunscreen, like what else can you do with sunscreen? It's when I find formulations like this that I'm like, oh my God, yes, like this is why I love Korean sunscreen, because they just seem to come out with new innovative formulations, textures, how it feels on the skin. Like this is just amazing. If you have oily skin, you'll absolutely love this. You put it on and it feels like it's gone. You're smooth though, you're hydrated, you're soothed. Really, really like this one. Okay, let's talk about reapplication. Now, reapplication is kind of annoying, you know, because you have to make sure that everything's rubbed in properly. You have to make sure that it's not caught in your hairline, all that kind of stuff. And that's why I love roll-on sticks. Not sprays. I'm not massively into sprays, even though I do really want to try them. But these are great for reapplication when you have a base sunscreen on. And if you do enough passes of these on your skin, I'm pretty sure your face will be sufficiently covered. Okay, one of my favorite brands, especially for sunscreen, is Tokubo. This is one of those brands whose sunscreen truly went viral because it's nice, because it's good. Of course, sunscreen stick, really easy to reapply. Just glide it over your face. If you're oily in particular, particular, or if you find that the sheen that you get from a lot of sunscreens with reapplication is too shiny for you, this has a really nice mattifying effect to it. They do say that anti-sebum is one of the product's benefits. It's got this like powder in it. I can't remember what it was, but there's like this powder that kind of like soaks up all those oils and leaves your skin looking mattified, but really smooth to the touch as well. Oh, this is SPF 50 plus PA 4 plus is the Cotton Soft Sun Stick. This is a mix of chemical and mineral filters. For me, obviously, it's going to leave no white cast. However, if you do have black skin, deeper skin tones, you may find that this might leave a little bit of a white cast. They do have their, I guess you could say, like normal sunscreen version of this, which doesn't leave a white cast. But if you are looking for something completely cast free, why not check out the Abib Quick Sun Stick Protection Bar. Again, SPF 50 plus, PA 4 pluses. Look at the shape. Look at the shape. I love this. Simple things like this. Simple things like changing the shape of a sunscreen stick to work with the contours of your face, making that user experience so much more enjoyable. It's a bit grimy, I use it a lot. But obviously you can just glide this around the contours of your face. If you haven't got a beard, you can obviously do it around your chin, up and down your neck, behind your ears, on top of your ears, around your nose contours, your forehead, your face, basically, so easily, simply because they decided to curve that stick look. It's scentless, it's clear. Think Supergoop Unseen Sunscreen, but without that kind of like weird matte oiliness, do you know what I mean? But again, it does leave your skin with that powdery soft touch finish, which I feel is something that is quite common in sunscreen sticks. Ingredient wise, we have, look at that, we have green tea leaf extract, great for soothing the skin. It's an antioxidant, which we know works great alongside UV filters. Cucumber, again, just soothing. Centella Asiatica, again, soothing, healing, and then aloe leaf extract, which is nice and hydrating. But we also have ceramides in here as well, so a bit of a pick-me-up for your skin barrier too. I absolutely love this. I love this so much. Do I love it better than Tocobo? I think I do. Now, I've left this one for last because, again, this is one that I'm still, like, mid-using. I feel with sunscreens, once you've used it for a day, you know about the user experience, how it felt on your skin, whether it's done your face, your eyes, you know, whether it was easy to reapply. That's all kind of, you kind of really need to know, because if it's a certified sunscreen, it's going to protect you, right? But this is the Mary and May Vegan Peptide Bacuchiol Sun Stick, SPF 50 plus PA 4 pluses. Now, usually when it comes to things like crazy actives and sunscreens, I'm like, I don't really see the point. Like if this was retinol in a sunscreen, I'd be like, that's a bit silly. But because it's bacuchiol, I think it's quite nice to have a little extra something in your sunscreen. You know, things like exfoliants, retinols, I'm like, just do it in the evening, it's fine. But you know, this is pretty harmless, to be honest. So you know, you have those potential anti-aging effects of bacuchiol. I'll be honest, I don't know a whole lot about it. I've never really been really that interested in it, in bacuchiol. But we have peptides in here as well. So I guess you can say this is an attempt at an anti-aging sunscreen. I would say sunscreen by default is probably one of, and retinol is a great anti-aging product anyway. But you know, this has a few extra perks. But again, if you're oily skinned, this is a great oil absorbing sunscreen stick. Again, it has those particles, like powdery particles in to help like suck up all that excess sebum. So again, when you're sat out in the sun, you're out and about, you're feeling a little bit greasy from your sunscreen reapplication, swoop this over and it's going to kind of mattify you and bring all those oils and greasiness right down. And again, just a really nice, convenient, degreasing, de-oiling sunscreen. So those are some of my top picks for Korean sunscreens to use this summer. Let me know if you've used any of these before, if you like them, if you didn't like them, let me know in the comments down below. And any sunscreens that I should try, because I go through sunscreens like I do cleansers, you know, it's something I use daily, all the time, numerous times daily. So let me know if there's any other sunscreens I should check out. And thanks again to Style Korean for sponsoring today's video. Don't forget to check out everything that they have to offer. All product links, of course, will be in the description box down below. You can check out some more product reviews here, some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.